People think that making a paper craft is easy, but is it actually that uncomplicated as it seems? I guess it's time for me to take you all behind the scenes of making the Qantas A380 paper craft. Dropping the intro in 3, 2... Before starting this information and tips and tricks session, I would like to tell you all that this video has been shot in a total time span of 80 hours, excluding the cutting of the parts which has not been shown in the video, and it has been time-lapsed by 600 times for you all to see the complete making of this paper craft. I hope you all like it. Do not forget to subscribe to the channel if you haven't to stay updated regarding some great news and information about aviation and paper craft. Hello guys, I hope you all are doing really well out there, staying safe and staying healthy. Before starting this video, I would like to thank you all for showing so much of support for the Qantas A380 paper craft video. That only made me think that I should post a time-lapse video of the same, showing you all what goes on behind the scene, except for the common 5-minute stop-motion video that you guys usually see. So let's make this video really informative one. I'll be sharing lots of fun facts regarding the Qantas A380 and A380 aircraft as a whole. Plus, I would be giving you guys tips and tricks to make this paper craft a really good one. So let's get started. Firstly, as you're seeing, the parts of the fuselage is what we focus on for 5 days. From cutting the parts, the formers, and joining them correctly, piece by piece, and also shooting the stop motion video simultaneously. The shots taken after each piece moved ahead in the frame and joining them in between the shot makes the whole process of making the paper craft a rather tedious one. Many people have this in their minds that it's easy to make a paper craft. Well, to some extent I agree to that fact. It is easy for someone who has been doing it for a long time and has a good hold on his skills. But someone who's making it for the first time, it's definitely not easy for him. And we, through the paper craft videos, aim to provide information and tips to make it easy for even a beginner to make a good paper craft. Moreover, the simultaneous shoot of the making adds on to the process, which makes it even more difficult. Talking about the tips, here are a few that I would like to share. First, the part that you're seeing on the screen. I have insisted on this part for a long time now. In every paper craft, you will see this part. And in my previous video of tips and tricks, I had focused on this. I would say that this part is the most important part of the whole template. The part is made to position in such a way that it holds the fuselage in a correct shape from the inside, as well as holds the wing in the upper position like it should be. If the placing and positioning of this part is incorrect, then the wings of the aircraft can fall down and touch the ground, which in turn would affect the engines and hence ruin the whole look of the aircraft. Secondly, the formers. If you don't know what formers are, you need not worry about it. You can see the previous video of tips and tricks. It's in the link above. Formers are again one of the most important part as they give a rigidness to the aircraft and also maintains the shape of it throughout. So make sure you place the formers at the correct position and in a correct manner. Well, this is just a small paper craft of the massive A380. Hence, we can't even compare the making and assembly of those in real ones to that we make. But there is one similarity between the making of real A380 and a paper craft. This might create a spark in your mind. How does assembly of a giant aircraft be similar to making a paper craft? Well, don't stress yourself. I'm here to tell you all about it. Let me start by telling you about the assembly and making of the real A380s. Airbus has various branches in different parts of the world, and the Airbus aircrafts are built in various different sections there. The same is with the A380. This mega plane has been divided into sections including the fuselage, the vertical tailplanes, the horizontal tailplanes, and wings. Furthermore, the making of these are also distributed. The nose and the center fuselage of the aircraft is made in Saint-Nazaire, France. The rear fuselage and the vertical tail fan is made in Hamburg, Germany, while the wings of the A380 are made in Broughton, Wales, and the horizontal tail fins are made in Cadiz in Spain. With such a widespread making of the different section in different countries, how is it possible to bring them to one location? Well, many paths journey to the final destination in Toulouse starts in the waters. The paths are carried in ships and boats, specially made for the easy and safe transportation of these A380 paths, called the Ro-Ro ships. When they reach the port of France, they are carried in giant trucks capable of withstanding such high loads. Moving through many villages of France, the paths of the A380 reach the final assembly line in Toulouse. However, there's one part that doesn't have to travel by road or water, and that is the vertical tail fin. The giant super transporter, Airbus Beluga, has the capability to carry directly from Hamburg to Toulouse. And finally, after it has reached Toulouse, it takes hundreds of workers to assemble the aircraft in a span of 80 days. So, did you get any similarity? Yes, it's the way how the real A380 is made, in different sections. That's how we make our paper craft as well. The fuselage first, the wings second, the engines third, and finally, the gears. This aircraft has been in the skies for over a decade and a half. Seeing such an airplane being grounded that has held so many records for the longest non-stop flights is painful. Talking about these longest non-stop flights, the Qantas also has had an A380 amongst many other A380s that has once held a record of longest non-stop flight from Sydney in Australia to Dallas in United States. However, that's not the case now. Currently, the record of the longest non-stop flight in the world is being held by Singapore Airlines Special A350-900 ULR, Ultra Long Range, from Changi Airport in Singapore to Newark Airport in the United States. With the introduction of A380 in various renowned airlines, many airports had to make a lot of changes, from increasing their capabilities of handling passengers to making many changes into their jet bridges as well. Next up is another important factor, the wings. We'll be making this for the next 3 days. This aircraft has a very unique gull wing design. Therefore, while making the wings of the A380 paper craft, make sure that the shape of the inner skeleton of the paper craft is correct. You can keep an image of the wings of the A380 for reference. This will help you determine the correct positioning and framing of the inner skeleton. This is important as the inner combination of parts will help you make the apt and correct outer covering for the wings with a perfect shape. Well, since we are talking about the wings, did you know that the A380 has the largest wingspan in any commercial passenger aircraft? It's of approximately 80 meters. That is even more than the width of a football field. This in turn increases the fuel storage of this giant, as the fuel is stored in the wings only, with a massive capacity of 320,000 liters. With this amount of fuel, the A380 has the capacity to fly a distance of 15,700 kilometers and is also considered as one of the longest range airliners. It's no shock that this much capacity of fuel is required to fly such a long distance with so many cargo and passengers. Talking about the passengers, the A380 has a seating capacity of 800. But due to the various comforting classes offered within this aircraft, the actual capacity of the aircraft goes down to anywhere between 480 to 525. It is rightly said, every great thing requires great sacrifice. In the terms of A380, it is a sacrifice of money. A whooping $446 million. That's what it takes to get one A380 in your fleet. That is the reason many airlines in the world do not have these aircraft. They think it is better to buy smaller and more number of aircrafts for their routes. And also the fact that the number of seats in those are easy to fill. Talking about another important part of an aircraft, the vertical and horizontal tailplanes. These tailplanes are also called as stabilizers, as they provide stability to the aircraft when a sudden gush of wind creates heavy turbulences, and also controls the pitch of the aircraft. Moving on to our third element, the engines. We focus on these for 3 days. When you look at its making, you might think, why does it take 3 days to make these? Well, you're seeing the making of just one engine, but we have to make 4 such engines for this aircraft. That is the reason it takes time to cut it out and assemble it part by part. Well, there is no such tip in particular about making the engines, but many people try to take shortcuts in these by not putting in some parts. Please, that is not recommended at all. You might save time, but there might be issues later on with its durability. You have to use all the given parts in the template, no shortcuts at all. Sharing some great information about the A380, the engines of the A380 are also one of its kind. There are 2 major companies that make the engines for this aircraft. The most popular one is the Rolls-Royce that makes the Trent 900 engine type for these aircrafts. The other one is made by Pratt & Whitney, named as GP7200. These engines are so massive and powerful that it has the capability to lift the 600-ton aircraft. Talking numbers, one engine has a capability of producing 70,000 pounds of thrust. That means the 4 engines on the A380 produces a thrust of 280,000 pounds. A question for you all. What do I mean when I say that the weight of the A380 is 600 tons? Do write your answers in the comment section below. Moving on to our next and the last 2 tips that I would like to give you. I have never mentioned these in my videos, so please listen to these very carefully. First, when the aircraft is completed, you might often see that the rear fuselage is touching the ground and the nose in the front fuselage is in a lifted position, like this. Why does that happen? It's because the weight of the rear fuselage is heavier compared to the front fuselage. So, what can we do to prevent such a condition? The answer is really simple and easy. When you're making the paper craft, make sure that you stick a counterweight at the 3rd or the 4th former that you'll put. This will make the front fuselage heavy, balancing the aircraft and making it stand on its gears properly. Second, and rather the tip that has been the most asked for, how to stop the print on the paper from fading. Many people have raised an issue saying that the print on the paper is fading with time, and how can we stop that from happening? When this question was asked to me first, I didn't give much heed to it until this happened with my paper craft. So I tried a couple of things and came up with the solution for these that I'm going to share it with you right now. When your aircraft model is complete, brush up the whole paper craft with a white adhesive and let it dry completely. When the adhesive is dried completely, use a varnish spray and spray a layer on it. This will benefit you in 3 ways. First, this will bring rigidness to your paper craft. Second, it will bring a nice shine and a gloss finish to it. And third, it will prevent the fading of the print on the paper. That is how you can do it. Now you all have a brief idea of how the working takes place, what I do behind the cameras and much more. The complete making of an A380 paper craft took me around 14 days. Depending upon your speed of work, you can take a buffer of 2 days. This marks the end of this video. I hope you guys really liked it. Thank you so much for watching it. If you have any queries or suggestions, do not hesitate to write it in the comment section below. Please subscribe to the channel and hit the bell icon as well to not miss any updates about the next videos. Follow me on Instagram and Facebook. The link is in the description below. Signing off, until next time.